Welding is a process that uses electric to bring a particular diameter electrode to its kindling point and join two metallic pieces of metal together. Each type of material, from steel to stainless to aluminum, all have different melting points. But typically on a GMAW MIG welding arc, you could reach temperatures of 10,000 degrees at the arc. Yeah, MIG welding and TIG welding is a common term for GMAW, which stands for gas metal arc welding, and GTAW, which is gas tungsten arc welding. GMAW is more of an automatic process where you have a filler material, it's loaded into the welding machine, you depress a trigger, and that material automatically dispenses out. It's generated an arc, and you fuse two pieces of metal together. Where TIG welding, the process of adding the filler is most times manual, when a person takes that material and adds it into the electric with the arc, and then joins those two pieces of material together. Different applications lend themselves to MIG welding versus TIG welding. Again, for efficiencies, MIG welding is most times an automatic process where an operator can just pull a trigger, the material is dispensed, it fuses those metals together. Where TIG welding requires a little bit more skill set, because you have both hands need to be used, one holding the torch, one holding the filler material, unless you get into a robotic scenario, which, you know, we have the capabilities here as well.
Okay, cool.
Robotic welding is something PCI ventured into about 9 years ago. What that is, it's basically, it uses a robotic arm to hold a type of power supply and do that process just with a robotic arm versus a manual process. We have two robotic welders here. Both of those are die hand machines and sales, and they use a H-frame design, which we can take apart up to probably 60 inches wide, and it can be up to 1,000 pounds, put it on there, and we have GMAW, which is commonly referred to as MIG welding. MIG welding power supplies hooked up to those, so we have two cells that are capable of that. So one of the parts that we've done on that machine very repetitiously over the last couple of years is a part for the alternate energy division, and it takes a box of materials that we weld together, and they're relatively thin, but we were traveling in upwards of like 30, 40 inches a minute. So when you have a part that has multiple areas that needs welding on it, and we're traveling at 30 to 40 inches a minute, and you have, you know, 100 plus inches a minute of welding on it, you're talking a couple minutes to produce a part, whereas if you did that manually, you know, you might be there for, you know, 30 minutes to weld that part. So it significantly reduces weld time, which translates into cheaper costs for our customers. One of the more challenging pieces was actually, as far as design, a very simplistic part, but the tolerances were very strenuous as far as us being able to hold a tight tolerance on a small part. So anytime you have heat introduced into metal, you get warping and distortion, and we had a part that, like I said, it was very simple, but there was a lot of heat input into a small area, which the tolerance between, you know, lug to lug or dimension on the print was very hard to achieve. So we had some experts in that helped us with some fixturing that we, you know, designed here, and we were able to achieve that over some time.